one of these men going to prove dominance and get a championship opportunity, and Sheamus out of the box quickly.
Sheamus wasting absolutely no time trying to get off to a strong start here. Wicked right hands and uppercuts from the Celtic Warrior.
Sheamus, one of the most decorated athletes in WWE history when you look at the statistics. A four-time world champion knocked down by the dropkick by Cesaro. Two-time United States title holder, King of the Ring winner, Royal Rumble winner, Money in the Bank winner.
Those accomplishments, though, play a huge part in the mental state of Sheamus, who has felt underappreciated here in WWE. He called Cesaro the darling of the WWE Universe.
Well, mentioning the WWE Universe, Cesaro said he's had his list of doubters, but the Cesaro section has never doubted him because of moves like that. Vicious uppercut to the jaw of Sheamus.
Cesaro embraced this series because he said it's solely about your in-ring ability, what you bring to the dance once that bell rings.
And Cesaro taking the fight outside, and Sheamus, ooh, Cesaro landed on the apron, and Cesaro taking out Sheamus.
Cesaro told me he may be pulling a few tricks out of the bag tonight.
Oh, what an uppercut by Cesaro. Cesaro's repertoire is so deep, so diverse. The guy does things that you've never seen before.
I just don't think there's any doubt. Momentum, of course, is in a Cesaro's corner as well. Three straight wins over Sheamus. And Sheamus, though!
Oh.
And Cesaro hit hard. And remember, the lower back, Sheamus cover quickly and a kick out.
Yeah, what's amazing about this series is that ever since that lower back injury occurred, Cesaro's never been 100%.
Yeah, and Sheamus now going to work on the back. We show you how it happened. Sheamus launching Cesaro into the ring post in match number two of this series. And Cesaro has never been able to get that back to 100%.
Well, you can ask any superstar on the WWE roster. After a match with Sheamus, you're nowhere near 100% at any time. Cesaro's had six of them.
Make it seven here tonight. And Sheamus, the Irish curse backbreaker again. You see the kinesio tape pointing out the injured area of the back for Cesaro.
As far as Sheamus is concerned, that kinesio tape might as well be a big target.
That's what he's using it as. A bullseye is, again, Sheamus. Knee right to the spine.
Well, Cesaro had to expect this coming in. I mean, that's the one thing about this series. You become very familiar with your opponent, familiar with his tendencies, familiar with his offense.
Saw Sheamus come out of the box quickly, looking to try to grab that momentum back. But since the early part of this matchup, we've been back and forth. Cesaro into the corner. Sheamus fouls it up. Wow, that was unique.
Something I don't think I've ever seen that.
Watching his full 270-pound frame. Cesaro stunned. Sheamus top rope with a clothesline. Cover isn't enough to win match seven and a kick out at two.
Sheamus just trying to catch Cesaro off guard a little bit, give him something he hasn't seen before.
Well, to your point earlier about learning the other opponent's tendencies, you've got to change it up. Seven games deep, you have to change your strategy a little bit.
Sheamus looking for the Celtic cross. Got Cesaro, though, who's able to roll through. Shoulders down, kick out two. And Sheamus again planting Cesaro. Is it enough to win the matchup? Hooks the leg, powering out.
One thing Cesaro talked about in this series was his virtue of patience. Not getting bent out of shape because he was down 3-0. Understanding that it's not a sprint, it's a marathon.
Hey, Sheamus out of the corner. Back it up now. One, two, come on.
Sheamus respond now, blowing that 3-0 lead. Uppercut from Sheamus, right hand by Cesaro.
Sheamus responding with a few uppercuts of his own.
Shoulder first into the post. Could be the opening Cesaro needs, and that was an uppercut right to the back of the head. These guys have thrown everything in their arsenal at each other over this seven-match series.
I can't imagine how Cesaro and Sheamus feel every morning after one of these matches, how much their bodies have to ache after these battles.
Well, they got to put it behind them tonight. Dig down deep for one more match.
And Cesaro feeling it.
Cesaro with the uppercut, and the uppercut trains on the tracks.
All aboard!
And Cesaro beating Sheamus. Tornado DDT, cover, hook of the leg. Almost had him near fall.
Again, you see Cesaro wincing in pain there. Every move, especially a move like a tornado DDT, takes a great deal of impact.
That's the problem with a back injury. And almost any offensive maneuver requires you to use your core and your back strength, including most of Cesaro's offense.
Cesaro on the move.
Was that a 619? It was. Cesaro with a 619 out of Rey Mysterio's playbook. And now for the top rope, crossbody, lateral press to win the series. Sheamus in 2.5.
If you run out of moves in your own arsenal, borrow from somebody else's.
Why not? Sure, Sheamus wasn't expecting that.
Cesaro could be looking for the neutralizer.
He was, but Sheamus able to backdrop it, misses with a clothesline. And there's that springboard corkscrew uppercut. And again, Sheamus survives. We got to take another look at the 619.
Look at this.
This wasn't pretty, but it was effective.
Hey, we've said it several times in this match. How are you going to shock your opponent? How are you going to do something your opponent does not expect to happen?
In a battle like this, neither Sheamus nor Cesaro are concerned with style points.
Cesaro calling for the Cesaro swing on Sheamus.
Oh, wow. Hop kick to the jaw.
Sheamus, I think he had the tights.
You're right.
Again, an Irish curse backbreaker. Again, a cover by Sheamus. Can he get him this time? And another near fall. And now you got to wonder when the frustration's going to start to settle in with Sheamus.
It doesn't look like frustration to me. That looks like pure anger.
Oh, again, the backbreaker. And another one as the punishment continues. Does Cesaro have anything left? And he does, barely.
Cesaro just will not stay down. It's almost disrespectful to Sheamus every time Cesaro kicks out.
Sheamus may be looking for the clover leaf here. He won one of the matchups in this series with this submission move made famous by Dean Malenko. And here we go. Look at this. Clover leaf's locked in. Cesaro with nowhere to go. He's got to try to make it to the bottom rope. Use those long arms to force the break here. Fingertip away. Almost there. Sheamus though drags it back to the center of the ring. Cesaro going to roll over. Rolls up Sheamus. That's how he won one of the matches in this series.
Sheamus won't make the same mistake twice. He's got Cesaro up.
Oh, my God!
That could be fatal.
Good night, Cesaro. How on earth was he able to get the shoulder up?
I think it's pure instinct there for Cesaro, but I can't imagine how much pain and agony that lower back is in.
That picture right there. That tells the entire story of this seven-match series. It's been physical, exhausting, competitive.
You can see Cesaro's face. His body is racked with pain right now. And Sheamus is in the driver's seat.
And he may be looking for the bro kick to end this. Cesaro, though, ducks over the bro. Cover, kick out two. Cesaro swing.
One more time.
How is Cesaro's back holding up?
The reason why they call him the Swiss Superman.
He's going to look for a submission of his own. Sharpshooter. Sharpshooter.
In the center of the ring.
Trying to force the break. Cesaro with a sharpshooter locked in at Sheamus.
I think you hit it right on the head, Cole. That lower back of Cesaro. Didn't allow Cesaro to sink the sharpshooter in as deeply as he normally would.
A blessing in disguise for Sheamus. Allowed him to make it to the rope and break the hold.
Still a fair amount of damage done to Sheamus in that submission. What's Cesaro got in mind? There's no way.
Not with a bad back.
No way.
He just doesn't have anything left. Just couldn't do it. Yeah, a healthy Cesaro does that, but not one with a banged up back.
Sheamus looking for white noise?
Yeah, on the apron. Cesaro, though, with a boot to the face.
Cesaro went head first into Sheamus.
Tope Suicida head first, literally first connecting with Sheamus, but then
goodness.
Cesaro spiking himself.
I want to see if we can get a look here. Watch Cesaro lands on his head. Cesaro's eyes literally rolled up the back of his head after he hit. Guys, this is what these two are going to put themselves through to win this best of seven series. But how much more can they take? Cesaro, bad back, bad shoulder, bad neck.
Broken neck.
And Sheamus. For dominance and victory. No.
Let's look at this again. Cesaro willing to absolutely destroy his own body. Look at this. First into Sheamus, and then, God, that's hard to watch.
God.
Cesaro looking for victory at any cost.
That kick out had to be on instinct alone off the road kick, and now Sheamus is frustrated.
Well, think about it, Cesaro's in this match, but is Cesaro capable of doing anything now to bring some sort of offensive way?
Notice how Sheamus now is targeted the neck. After Cesaro landed on his head and his neck moments ago, Sheamus has turned his offense toward that. Ouch! Cesaro though caught him! Clothesline!
Go for it!
Neutralizer!
No way!
For the win! No! Kick out!
I thought Cesaro was gonna steal it. I thought Cesaro was gonna steal this match at that moment.
Everybody in this arena had the very same thought. Cesaro nailing the neutralizer, but somehow, some way, Sheamus able to dig deep and survive.
Indeed it is, and I do not know how you could expect any more out of two individuals. These two men fighting to establish dominance, fighting for a future championship opportunity.
Cesaro cracking his neck back into place. Like a Swiss cyborg tonight.
Come on, you piece of crap! Oh, come on!
How much more punishment can these two men take? How much more can they dish out? Cesaro says, I got plenty left.
Oh, does he ever? Davis kind of challenged him. Show me what you got, Cesaro. Show me how much you have left.
Oh,
Sheamus taking out Cesaro.
A lot of upper body power left in Sheamus, able to pull himself to the top rope.
Strong kick! That almost collapsed the jaw of Sheamus.
A buffet of uppercuts going on in this match.
Look at the vertical leap.
Watch the jaw.
First the uppercut.
Watch the jaw here. Oh my God.
Such precision by Cesaro.
But guys, there's a reason tonight is named Clash of Champions. Because these two men showing what being champions are all about. Battling for a championship opportunity.
Oh my goodness.
A headbutt dropping Cesaro on the bad back on the apron.
Now, what Sheamus gonna do? No way. No way, Sheamus.
This isn't gonna be good.
Oh, on the top rope!
Cesaro caught him with an uppercut. I don't know what Sheamus was attempting to do, but the Celtic Warrior was caught with a massive uppercut.
And watch this again.
The better angle here.
Sheamus off the top, and watch Cesaro's right arm.
Bang! Oh, God. White noise!
Noise by Sheamus!
White noise on the floor.
Guys, what else can these two do to each other? They've done everything possible, and they're still going.
Both of these superstars exhausted, running on pure instinct. But you're right, on a long enough timeline, you're going to run out of things to do.
Off the post, and now the clothesline sends both men into the WWE Universe.
True battle of attrition between Cesaro and Sheamus.
Like Cesaro might have injured his arm.
Okay, you see our ringside doctors down there attending to both Cesaro and Sheamus.
Understandably so. Cesaro and Sheamus have been through a car crash tonight.
They have beaten the hell out of each other.
Two of the toughest, most physical men in the WWE locker room.
Mick Foley wanted physical dominance to be established. I don't think he wanted two superstars to destroy one another.
Well, obviously the official had to stop the match. Sheamus and Cesaro, at least according to the ringside doctors, cannot go.
One arm.
It's over.
I can fight with one arm.
Over. I can't let you go on.
I fought with one arm before.
The doctor, no.
Jesus.
The doctor says
no. Here's Cesaro saying he wants to still fight. The doctors, I mean, you have to let the doctors use their discretion.
You gotta think about long-term health.
Be a career-threatening situation for both of these superstars.
Sheamus can't even make it to his feet by himself.
Hey, hey, Sheamus, let us help you. Let me help you. Come on.
We need help, man.
Hey, Sheamus, we're going to help you.
And understand the champion's mentality of both Sheamus and Cesaro. They want to keep fighting. This is for the good of their careers. This is for their well-being.
In this case, obviously, emotions are going to take over. These men realized how important this match was.
We can understand the passion of the WWE fans here tonight, but again, Sheamus and Cesaro did everything they could. They did everything humanly possible to their bodies. The officials making the decision that they cannot continue.
They did everything humanly possible and then some.
And at this point, what happens to this best of seven series? Cesaro says he's ready to go. He wants to continue this thing. Sheamus being helped back to the locker room area.
I don't know that Sheamus is being helped back to the locker room as much as forced.
Yeah.